Thank you for joining me for another edition of the Bob Sullivan Show. Today I have on with me from LadyFootball.com, Leslie Tarlett and Mike Karmowski. Is it Karmowski?
It's Karmowski.
Karmowski.
It's okay, it's a long one.
How are you guys doing today?
Good, good. Thanks.
Oh, doing great, Bob. Thanks for having us on.
Well, let me just to get started, Leslie, would you like to tell everybody about ladiesfootball.com a little bit and introduce everybody to the world?
Sure. Okay, we designed ladiesfootball.com to inform women about the NFL, the teams, the players, how the game is played, how to play fantasy football, the backstories, all of this stuff, but told in a female-friendly way. So, the way we came up with the idea, let me kind of tell you about my background. In high school, I was a precision dancer in the band, and I marched on the football field at halftime. And along with everybody else, I would cheer, and it was very exciting, and the whole time, I didn't even understand what a down was. Then later in college, I learned about the game in more detail, and then really have enjoyed it ever since. But I've known lots of women over the years that watch football religiously that still have no idea how the game is played. And then in 2008, I had also heard a lot about fantasy football. I thought, you know, what the heck is this fantasy football? So I went online and I said, oh, let me just set up a team. And then pretty soon I drafted 11 other teams and I started to learn about fantasy football. But up until then, I knew nothing about it. Mm-hmm. So this gave me the idea to develop a site that's female-friendly to help women who are informed and those that are uninformed to go to a place that is designed with them in mind. That's really how we came up with the idea for Ladies Football.
Well, Mike, I know you can agree with this. I've never gotten into fantasy football. I'm still on the fence with it. I'm in the pro fantasy football, that is. I'm still in the college fantasy football. And that is, I mean, it's a lot easier. It's a lot more laid back than pro fantasy football because there's so many players that you don't really have to study up to be good at it. And everybody's in it till the end. As a female, how difficult is it to win a fantasy league against a bunch of men and not have it men get upset with you?
Well, my league is called Florida Fantasy Conference, and as I said, I started in 2008, and I had mostly men as team owners, and the very first year, a woman won. Mm-hmm. I came in last, because I had no idea what I was doing.
Yeah.
And then the second year, I really researched and studied hard and kind of figured out how to play and did it unemotionally, and I actually won that year. And then since then, another female has won. So 3 years in a row, we had a female winner, and then last year, we had a man won. So it's very competitive, and they do get really, you know, they don't get upset. They love the competition, but I think the guy that won last year was like, oh, I finally won. Thank goodness.
Yeah.
So it's just a great time. But we still only have maybe three or four of the teams are female, and everybody else is owned by a male.
So with fantasy football, when you're winning these leagues and beating men in these leagues, how often, year in, year out, how much turnover is there in your league of how many more women have joined versus joined fantasy football leagues since your website began?
Well, we've had, you know, of course we've had turnover like any other league does. We have 12 teams, some leagues only have 10, but we like having 12. And we've had, I think, one woman drop out and a couple join since the beginning, so we've had probably worse turnover in the male side than on the female side. We only really had one female drop off.
When you do fantasy football, what's your since I haven't gotten into it as much, what is your what are your first few rounds like? What are you looking for when you're drafting?
Well, it's interesting because in the past, when I first started, actually the first year I didn't even read anything. I just jumped in and really didn't do very well. But the second year when I did my research, a lot of the experts would tell you to draft, you know, two running backs the first two rounds, a running back each of the first two rounds, then a quarterback, and then a wide receiver the fourth and fifth round. And if, let's say, because of my second year, I was very last pick, just randomly became the 12th pick, that if you see somebody, you know, everybody's taking running backs, and you can get a high-end wide receiver instead. So I followed that format very religiously in the second year, and actually ended up winning. But since then, because, the scoring really hasn't changed, but quarterbacks seem to be what everyone's picking, running backs and quarterbacks in the first round. But it used to be that you would not pick a quarterback in, until maybe the third or fourth round. So things have changed a little bit. But if you can get one of the top quarterbacks in the first round, that's advised, especially if you're in the first few picks. If you're towards the, let's say 9 through 12, then you probably pick a running back. And then, second round, everybody tries to get running backs or wide receivers.
Have you determined your draft position yet for this upcoming season, or are you still in the process of getting that figured out?
We have already determined it, and the way that we do it is based on last year's final standing. So if you were the winner last year, you're the last pick, unless there's new teams brought in. A new team has to go to the bottom, of course. And then if you were the worst team, you get the pick first. Thank goodness I'm not picking first, but I'm definitely not in the bottom half. So I didn't do that great last year.
Where are you, what are you looking for in your team this year? Who did you, do you have keepers? Who are you keeping? Who are you letting go? Or who are you going to go after with your first pick?
Well, that's interesting. I've just been doing the research now. And I'm really debating whether I go, for a quarterback. I love Aaron Rodgers and actually had him the year I won. But on the other hand, I might want to go for a running back, maybe an Arian Foster or Ray Rice. I love Ray Rice, and I think he's going to get, he's going to sign the deal. So I would love to have him as well. So I'm not 100% sure yet, but it would be one of those three players most likely.
Looking at these, what do you look out for? Because I tend to, if I've done the two times I've done fantasy football, I tend to stay away from running backs that just got a new deal. What are some no-nos that you look for when you're drafting?
Well, there's many, many different things, but right towards the end, I will start reading up on all the teams, and I wouldn't want to draft somebody that, let's say a running back that is working for a team that maybe I don't think it's going to do so hot. But maybe I would pick somebody lower ranked because they're with a great quarterback. Mm-hmm. Like I would love to pick like Greg Jennings because he's with, Rodgers. I might hesitate on picking a Denver running back until we see how, Peyton. A lot of different research, and of course you always look at the rankings. You get the cheat sheet and you can shuffle the rankings, but I look at a lot of different factors. I don't just necessarily follow exactly the order that they're given to us on the cheat sheet.
Who's somebody that you're definitely not going to, you don't want to touch at all, that you think is going to be a disaster this year?
Possibly Matt Forte. I'm sure there's others as well, but I was just recently thinking about him because I think he's also, you know, he probably won't get the deal that he wants. But now that Michael Bush is there, and that Forte, we're not sure he's 100%. So that's somebody that maybe ranked fairly high. In fact, I think he's ranked 7th or 8th, but I probably wouldn't necessarily pick him.
Where do you see Peyton Manning? How do you see him faring, not just in fantasy football, but overall this year?
I definitely wouldn't pick him in the first few picks, that's for sure. I really don't know. I mean, I'm 50-50 on him. Maybe 51-49. I think he's obviously, what an awesome quarterback, but how's he going to do in a new environment? Is he totally healthy? Will he stay healthy? Those are all questions that we don't know the answers to yet. So I'm excited to see how he plays, but not really sure that I would draft him.
What about on the on ladies football? What do you tend to look for what do you try to educate the women on? Not just fantasy wise, but real football wise. What are some main points that women tend to have problems with understanding? What are your key points that you help out with?
Well, first of all, we try to gear the website to accommodate someone that has absolutely no knowledge, up to somebody that really has a lot of knowledge and wants just a different place to go that's more female oriented. So you'll find on the site the basics of how to play football. You also find basics of fantasy football. So if somebody's interested but they're not really sure about it yet, they can go there and really see it spelled out. And then also we have, several people blogging, and we've done a review of, the top 100 players for the upcoming fantasy season, and we also have for women that maybe they follow football, they, go to the game and they are watching on TV with significant other and they'll cheer, but maybe they're interested in the background of the players, more of the people aspect of it. So we have a place called Guilty Pleasures that gives them kind of the background or the gossipy side of football. And there's also, we have party planning, with all kinds of different football things that women would be interested in.
What's your favorite guilty pleasure piece you've done on ladies football?
A couple. One is the body issue, of course, and we had a link to the body issue. That was really, just amazing pictures of men and women. Just beautiful. Yeah, they're basically naked but covered, as I'm sure you've seen it.
Yeah.
And now we've done some stuff on, Tom Brady and his background, and one that I think is really interesting is the background of Ocho Cinco and his texting and different things that he's interested in, and I find that very interesting. I think most women would.
What's one thing that keeps women away from football? Is it in ignorance of, like, maybe they don't know, or is it athletes being bad role models? What's the main thing that you've noticed with why women don't tend to watch football as much as men?
Well, I think there's several things. I mean, one, when they're, kids, if they didn't get involved in sports or watching sports, and, fortunately my brother was really into baseball and statistics, so early on, we'd come home from school and we would watch baseball, and then in college I started becoming really interested in football. So if you don't have that, you're not going to ever know that it's fun, and then you don't really know how the game is played, and then you're 35, it's unlikely you're going to go to someone and say, well, can you just explain the basics of the game? Because maybe you feel stupid or intimidated. And so I think those are the people that we want to those are some of the people that we want to reach out to. And there's also people that know everything about football, or at least the team that they follow. But there's really no really good sites out there that are catered towards women.
You're right.
Where you could ask a stupid question, and nobody's going to think you're stupid.
Have you been able to outsmart, since you've started this site and done more researching, have you been able to have a moment where, like, a guy's like, where you're like, yeah, you're not correct on that, or you correct them on some something during the game, like about a blitz or something? Have you been able to correct a guy on that since you've started?
Well, you know, over the years, I definitely will chime in on conversations, you know, especially at work. And that's one of the things, another area of the site that I haven't even mentioned yet, called Talking Points. And the idea behind Talking Points is that when you go in on Monday morning and all the guys are in the meeting and you're sitting there and you don't really know what they're talking about, here you have some bullet points of things to say. So that was the first area. But usually I haven't really disagreed in a verbal conversation with anyone. And hopefully on the site we get things correct. But I think as even I have, you know, more to learn about the, you know, the different players and stuff. I mean, everybody always has more that they can learn. And I think the more you learn, the more able you are to talk intelligently with other people.
Who's your favorite player in the NFL right now?
Oh, Aaron Rodgers by far.
By far. Why are you in all around? Are you just a Packers fan, or just a, are you a Aaron Rodgers fan just specifically?
You know, I'm really an Aaron Rodgers fan just specifically. I grew up in, outside of Philadelphia, so I was an Eagles fan.
Mm-hmm.
And then, so, yeah, a lot of Eagles players that I like, and I'll still follow them. And then I've also followed Washington Redskins. Most recently, over the last few years, I followed the Dallas Cowboys. I live in Miami, so of course, I see Dolphins games, but and I used to actually really hate Green Bay. You know, you have those certain teams that you hate.
Yeah.
And but then I got Aaron Rodgers on my team the second year, and that's the year that I, you know, won my league. And I started watching Green Bay, and I really started liking them. And I like the fact that they're owned by the fans, and so definitely, you know, just my absolute favorite player. He's really, really good, and he seems like a really upstanding guy as well.
Who are your, like, who are you looking forward to seeing with a new team this year? Like, what draft pick are you looking forward to most with Andrew Luck, Robert Griffin, or who's a maybe another pick that you're looking forward to watching?
Well, I think both of those guys are going to be very interesting, but especially RG3 because of, you know, Washington. And I've been, in the past, I lived outside of Washington, D.C., and I think it was, you know, it's going to be exciting to see if they can turn the team around and what's going to happen. So I think that's going to be really interesting. But, of course, you know, not as a draft pick, but, of course, everybody's going to be watching Peyton Manning, of course. That's going to be the really interesting one to see who he is now.
Do you see a like a like who's your favorite right now to win the go in the Super Bowl from the NFC and the AFC?
Okay, NFC, I would say probably somebody from the NFC East.
Okay.
And who knows? I think all, you know, I think Washington probably has the least likely chance, but I think Dallas, Giants, and Eagles have an awesome opportunity that any one of them could pull it out. From the AFC, good question. I don't know. I'm not really sure. I mean, I don't really think, you know, Baltimore is another team I watch. I don't really think that they could possibly pull it out. I mean, New England, of course, always has an opportunity. But I don't, that's not necessarily one I want to win the Super Bowl.
Yeah. How difficult is it in the to living in Miami with every year listening to them. I mean, they're looking for the next so-called Dan Marino. They've been searching for that for years now.
Yes.
How bad is that to listen to every year in, year out?
Yeah, it's just frustrating. It's very, very frustrating. And, you know, I think done in the past years. What's going to happen this year? I don't know. I don't really have a real optimistic outlook, but what do you think about the Dolphins?
I think the Dolphins are... I just think they're a poorly run organization, and I just don't know where, I mean, the wheel, I just don't think, I think they just never properly prepared for that time when Dan Marino was going to be gone. Like, they never drafted well when he was there, and, I mean, it showed with how many Super Bowls he won, and I don't see the guy that they drafted this year from Texas A&M, I can't remember his name.
Tannehill?
Yeah, Tannehill, yeah. Yeah, I just don't see him being a... I thought he went way higher than he should have, and I just don't see him being that next guy that they're looking for. And, I mean, I could be wrong, but he seems like more of a project than... the fans are really looking for.
Yeah, we definitely don't need any more projects.
Well,
you're always hopeful, especially when you live in the area. You're always hopeful, but it hasn't gone very well the last few years.
No, it hasn't. And is that something that is does that cause you to hate a team more as a fan of football to have to hear about, like, the fans' convoluted ways of how the team's going to be good? Because I live in Nebraska, and I have to hear year in, year out why Nebraska football is going to win the national championship. And any sane person knows that they're not going to win the national championship this year. It's a definite couple years out.
The fans say that they will win just because they're fans.
Right, yeah. And how difficult is that? Does that make you numb to Dolphins fans, or does that make you more so to dislike them? Because I grew up a Huskers fan, and the more I've grown up, the less I've liked them because of the fans.
Well, it's funny that you say that because, you know, as I said, I'm from the Philadelphia area. And my husband is from Miami and actually follows Dallas Cowboys. And that's when, you know, talk about people, you know, trash talk, and everybody trash talks about the Cowboys. But in Miami, I find it so different than Philadelphia. People will say, well, they can't say it like it is. Nobody has, you know, inflated ideas of how well the Dolphins are going to do. And I don't know if it's just because of the area or not. If you're in Philadelphia, oh my gosh, you know, no one's going to say a bad word about the Eagles. No one.
No.
And, you know, people grew up generations in the city of Philadelphia following the Eagles. And it's like part of the city. It's, you know, it's just so different when you're in an area like Miami that is a lot of transient people and people that have come here from other places. So you don't find people saying, you know, having delusions of grandeur too much on the Miami Dolphins. Now, I'm used to this trash talk about Dallas Cowboys because, you know, my husband is a diehard fan, and, you know, everywhere we go, there's always discussions, and people either hate them, and when they hate them, they really hate them. So, we're not around a lot of Dallas fans to hear people having delusions of grandeur about them, but...
Who do you dislike the most in the NFL? What team?
Probably the Patriots.
Ooh.
I know that they're probably a contender for the Super Bowl, but I hope not.
Are you a fan at all of on the Eagles, do you think that they're a legit contender this year?
The Eagles?
Yeah.
Yeah, I really do. I think that, you know, again, it's just like any other team, they have to get their act together and make it happen. And Vic really has to stay healthy and come through. But I think they have a very good chance. You know, again, I think anybody in the NFC East has a very good chance.
All right. And who do you think is going to be the MVP of your team this year in fantasy football?
Probably if I get him, Aaron Rodgers.
Of course, Aaron Rodgers.
Yes, if I get him. Now, I am the second pick, I hate to admit, because that means I finished next to last year. But I'm pretty sure I would pick him in my first round, although I'm not 100% yet. So we'll see what happens. I just keep doing research right up until the day of the draft.
Who's your go-to fantasy source?
Well, we have somebody that's writing on ladiesfootball.com that gives us a lot of information on fantasy football. And there's also a guy I love on his site called God Hates Losers.
Ooh.
I love that guy. He's got really good information. And, of course, I always go to ESPN and NFL.
I was hoping you were going to say that I was.
It's about Sullivan.
Oh no! Well, if you want the stupidest questions for fantasy football, you ask me.
Let me say that again.
If you want the stupidest questions, or if you don't want to know how to play fantasy football, you go to me. Also, do you want to throw in one pitch for ladies football again right before we go here?
Okay, can you hear me, Bob?
Yeah, I can.
Okay, sorry. So it sounds like it got cut off a little bit. Ladiesfootball.com is a site for women. It's going to help you learn how to play the game of football, how to understand. You can learn about the players, the team. You can get talking points so you can sound smart on Monday morning at the water cooler. It's the Savvy Girl Secret Weapon,
ladiesfootball.com. Beautiful. That is, I'm signing up for an account today on Ladies Football.
Great.
Even though I am not a lady, but I am interested.
Please, join. Hey, it's always a work in progress, but we love to have you on board, so.
Absolutely. Well, I appreciate you coming on, and I really appreciate it. And is there anything else you want to talk about before I let you go?
No, I really enjoyed it, and you can also talk to Mike.
Okay.
Like
we'll do. Thank you very much, Leslie.
Thank you, Brian.